College game day's here. This is the biggest game in the country this week. What's it like to, we hear this, keep the noise out. How difficult is that, though?
Honestly, it's, you think it's pretty difficult, but really we're so focused on, like, on our preparation and what it takes to win. When you really get focused on that and, what it takes to win, taking care of the outside noise is easy.
Couple games into your career at cornerback, I'm sure you're learning a lot on the fly. Kind of how are you settling in?
You know, I would say that I'm starting to get a little more comfortable out there, definitely for sure. I'm just getting game reps, because, you know, game reps are always 100% way different than practice reps. You know, everything's so situational and things like that. So as far as the situational part of the game, for me specifically, is where I feel like I'm starting to get the most comfortable with.
If I'm not mistaken, it was primarily quarterback for you in high school. Just what's been the biggest transition to corner this last 2 years, I guess? And I guess even last year you were playing more safety as well.
Yeah. Well, I was, the biggest difference is going from throwing the ball to tackling 230-pound backs, honestly. and then having to cover every single play, you know, which at quarterback, obviously, you're not covering nothing like that. So I would just say mainly the athletic strain, you know, the physical strain is way different playing DB, for sure.
Christian, what goes through your mind in the end zone the other day when you feel like you had really good coverage and then the flag comes down and y'all are trying to keep that game as wide as you could? Is it kind of like a, oh man, really, kind of moment?
Yeah, man, I mean, anytime, you know, you have you feel like you have good coverage and it's a penalty, you know, it's always unfortunate, but, you know, I try to control the things I can control. You know, I can't control whether the referee throws a pass interference flag or anything like that. So I just control what I can control and just move on to the next play, because there's nothing I can really do about it.
Rick, and then back to Wes.
Thanks, man. Christian, how do you prepare for a guy like Bryce Young who can beat you in so many different ways?
Yeah, Bryce is super duper talented. You know, with his game, you can't take anything for granted. You know, he's a great passer. He's a outstanding runner. So, you know, you got to be prepared in all facets of the game, whether that's tight coverage or constricting running lanes to scramble and things like that. You know, you got to focus on all facets of your game. Nothing can be lacking when playing a quarterback like Bryce.
Wes, and back to Adams.
Christian, what kind of preparation do y'all get from your receivers on a daily basis? It seems like that's something that it's almost like a game within a game throughout the week, because y'all's receivers are putting up huge numbers. How much does that help you?
For sure. Having the best wide receiver core in the country definitely helps you. Definitely helps you get prepared every week. You know, you're not seeing a slouch at all ever at practice. You know, you're getting a guy's 100% effort every week at practice, and I feel like that prepares us so much leading up to game day, just getting those high speed, real high value reps, because every rep with any receiver on our team is very, very valuable, because they're all super talented and they all have a lot to offer.
We didn't get an update on Jalen McCullough. Coach didn't have one, but the secondary has been strained by losing guys. Warren Burrell's out now. D. Williams is out for a while. We don't know about Jalen. How difficult is it, or how equipped are you guys to fill in holes when needed?
Yeah, you know, we have a lot of guys that we feel like we can lean on in our DB room. And, you know, we have a lot of great leadership within our room. So no matter who has to step up to the plate, no matter the situation, I feel like we're all going to do a great job in preparing whoever it is to take on that role, no matter what it is.
Two quick follow-ups. One to that is the versatility across training. A lot of you guys at different positions, does that sort of add to the confidence that regardless of who might be missing, like Jalen, that somebody's going to be able to step up?
Yeah, we all pride ourselves on being very versatile and playing Coach Martinez specifically likes to say we're DBs. You know, we're not limited to any position. You're not just a corner. You're not just a safety. You're not just a nickel or a star. You know, you play DB. So we all pride ourselves on being very versatile.
And you were talking about the practice of going up against those receivers. Do you see the work of you going up against them and the challenge they presented you paying off for them on offense? And you're like, yeah, that's what we saw in practice.
For sure. Definitely. Anytime there's a lot of success on Saturdays. You know, we definitely, as a defensive group, you know, look at each other and like, yeah, we've been, that makes sense. You know, we've been we've been seeing them make plays and do the things they've been doing all year, all fall and all spring. So, yeah.
Christian, you guys have been around D since he got here in January. For him to miss the first four games, I guess his first play is here was that punt return. What was that like? Were you on the punt team and just what was it like seeing
him? Yeah. I was on the punt return team, and man, we're so excited for D, man. We love D so much. We love everyone on our team, but just having him be down, you know, for the first 4 weeks and then him come back and make an explosive play like that, we were all just so incredibly ecstatic for him and just the opportunity that he set our team up for in that situation.
A couple more things. Were you guys surprised that he broke that? I know you had some big returns in junior college, and also did you guys give him a hard time for getting tackled by the punter?
Oh, always a hard time for getting tackled by the punter, man. But, you know, we've been seeing for all the fall and all the spring just the explosiveness that he brings at the punt return position. So I wouldn't say that we are surprised that it happened, but we all were very excited for D.
I got two questions for you. What have you seen from Alabama's offense, those receivers on tape so far?
On tape so far, you know, they're a very explosive group, all very very calculated in their route running, and all are threats down the field. You know, you can't take anyone on the receiving corps lightly at all.
And then secondly, I'm sure the answer to this is yes, but with Warren being out, is he playing a big role for you off the field, helping you prepare, helping you kind of watch that film and get ready each week?
Yeah, definitely. I would say even really before Warren had dealt with what he's dealing with now, he had been instrumental for me personally in developing the mental side of my game, and not only me but just all the corners in our room. He had been instrumental in developing just our mindset and our focus to the game.
Christian, there have been times in the past where Tennessee plays Alabama and just everything has to go absolutely perfect for Tennessee to be in the game. How much confidence do y'all have knowing that you feel like the way you're playing right now, you got a chance to go out there and just play football and win this game?
Yeah, I mean, that's what we do every Saturday, you know. We go out every Saturday with the mentality of doing everything we need to end up on the right side of the scoreboard when that clock hits four zeros, you know. We don't take anything for granted or anything like that, and we're gonna work for everything that we get, for sure.
Thanks, Christian.
Thank you.